that is known as mutations. Mutations are of different types. Can you tell me what are different types of mutations? Different types.
We have not learned this now.
Yeah. Mutations can be happen, mutations can happen by themselves. Okay. Due to exposure of UV rays, X-rays. Okay. It can happen by itself. Or we also can incident the mutations. We can incident the mutations by ourselves in the laboratory for some more hyperactivation of a gene or for silencing of new genes. So we can also incident mutations into the gene. Okay? Into a genetic material. So there are different types. Okay, now we will discuss genetically modified organisms first, then we will go to other types of mutations. Okay.
Okay, this is the genetic content of a DNA.
DNA. In one of the ways, you will have our genome in place. I'll take this is our genome in place. Okay. Now, and here this is also cut. Using molecular scissors, this is also cut here. This plasmid is also cut. Now we have plasmid like this. And we have a genome in this. Stop talking. We have genome in this and plasmid. Now we will use an enzyme called ligase. DNA ligase. Ligase is for attaching. It is just like it pays the cut ends of the DNA. DNA ligase. So when we give DNA ligase enzyme, now we have the plasmid like this and our genome interest in this get attached here to the plasmid. And we will get it plasmid with genome interest. It's very easy. You will infect the bacteria and you will insert this plasmid. Okay? Now bacteria with genetic material and the plasmid of your genome is this. Your genome is this. Okay, clear? This is how you insert the genome in this. And now you will grow this bacteria in a media. Like you will use nutrients, agar, media and you will grow this bacteria. Okay? And you will check for the presence of your genome interest. You will check for the presence of your genome interest. Okay. Now these genes can be inserted into animals, plants. Okay? Everywhere these can be used. Made it as a powder, we can use this. Okay? This is how we make recombinant DNA, we make genetically modified organisms using recombinant DNA technology or genetic engineering. Here, these are based completely on the enzymes we are using. Molecular scissors are those for cutting of the DNA and ligase is the enzyme for attaching back. Okay, and now we are inserting it using some enzymes which break the cell wall of the bacteria and then it will go inside. That is not required for you. This is a basic idea of DNA technology. Okay. Now we have genetically modified organisms. Why are those genetically modified organisms used? In plants. Plants may be for inserting few characters like increasing the nutrients, protecting the like resistance to the plant, or increasing the shelf life of a food, are very stable. When you take animals, what is the use? If you take cow, increasing the production of milk, increasing the amount of fat or decreasing the amount of fat in the milk. We have fat, right?
Yeah, low calorie milk.
Low calorie milk, all those different types of milk we have. So increasing or decreasing anything or silencing few genes, that is why we use different plants and animals. Okay, genetic engineering in plants and animals, that is useful. Production of genetically modified organisms. I'll give few examples of genetically modified organisms. Okay, it is golden rice.
Superma.
Flavor. Flavor. Tomato. And you have genetically modified mice. It's called as GM mice. These are the few examples of plants and animals genetically modified organisms. Golden rice, flavor flavor tomatoes, genetically modified mice and genetically modified yeast. And we have greedy bottle, greedy brinjal, bacillus thuringiensis cotton, bacillus thuringiensis like brinjal, many varieties we have. Okay, few examples I have given. What is the golden rice? Why is it used? It is golden rice. Which calorie we are increasing? Vitamin A. Deficiency of vitamin A causes which disease? Very good. It causes retinol or night blindness. Okay, we are increasing the vitamin A in the golden rice. That is the modification we are doing in the golden rice. What about flavor saver tomato? We are increasing the shelf life of it. Shelf life of the fruit or tomato vegetable. What are we doing here? Introducing a gene into it. What is the gene called as? Polygalactolonase. The gene we are inserting, okay, that will lead to modification and it will not help, it will not degrade the cell wall or cell membrane of the fruit, the outer shell, will not degrade it, so that it will protect and increase the cell shelf life of a fruit or any vegetable, okay, it will increase the shelf life. That is the importance of flavor saver tomato. That is the enzyme. Polygalactolonase. It is an enzyme which helps in degradation of the cell wall. Okay. Genetically modified mice. What are we doing in genetically modified mice? Like we can do anything we using mice because the mice genome is similar to the genome of human beings. So if we need any antibiotics which are monoclonal antibodies, you know. Those are the antibodies which are produced artificially and used, okay, for production of monoclonal antibodies we are using mice, and for increasing the HCG, size of the mice we are using HCG hormone, human growth hormone. Human growth hormone, what is the human growth hormone? Last year you have studied endocrine system. Somatotropin, that is a growth hormone. Somatotropin. You are studying in endocrine system. I have told you. Okay. We are using human growth hormone. We are increasing the human growth hormone. That is somatotropin. To increase the size of a mice, we are inserting this HDH into the mice to increase the size of the mice. Tropic, which increases the size. Somatostatin is the one which decreases, which inhibits the growth. Somatotropin, which increases, or somatostatin, which inhibits the growth. Static means to stop the growth. Okay, GM yeast. In genetically modified yeast is the smallest. Living organism?
No. Fungi.
It's a fungi. Okay. Unicellular fungi. Okay. And why are we using genetically modified yeast?
For insulin.
Yeah. The production of insulin. We are using for the production of insulin. We are inserting gene for insulin. Okay. We are inserting the gene of insulin and making it to reduce in the next generation. Insulin producing gene. Okay, these are the different places where we are using genetic engineering or RNA technology for production of different varieties. Here for increasing the vitamin A, here increasing the shelf life, here for increasing the size of the mice, and also we can use mice for different activities for the production of monoclonal antibodies. The first main example. In the next class, you will find out the importance of monoclonal antibodies and monoclonal antibodies. Monoclonal antibodies. If you are not asking you what are monoclonal antibodies, you will do it as a homework.
What are they?
Now I am not going to tell. You need to ask.
Germline mutations?
No.
Cancer.
color, you look like your father, your nose look like your mother, your hair texture is like your mother. If you have curly hair, they will tell like it's just your hair is just like your mother. They compare it, right? That is their validation. They have passed from your parents to children. Okay? That is the what is germline validation, somatic validation. Clear? Okay. Now, what are the factors affecting these mutations? Factors affecting mutations. Environmental factors. Environmental factors. Yeah.